And welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today we're talking about the top 10 animals created by science. Before we launch straight on into this video, I just want to remind you guys that we have an Instagram account, so go follow us at Most Amazing Official. You can also get some behind the scenes access to us and our fan community on Patreon, so I will leave the links to Instagram and Patreon in the description box down below. Coming in at number 10, we have a rat with an ear on its back.
Right.
Scientists in Japan grew a human ear on the back of a rat. The ear was made from human cartilage taken from a rib cage and grown with the purpose of being a replacement body part for people with deformities. Doctors in the UK have managed to grow a nose on a human arm, which is kind of cool, but an ear on a rat's back seems a little bit cruel. I'm assuming once that ear is ready, it's curtains for Mr. Rat. Coming in at number 9, we have GloFish. Imagine patenting a fish. While the term GloFish is patented and trademarked, and the product, if you will, is a fluorescent fish. Colors include electric green, sunburst orange, moonrise pink, starfire red, cosmic blue, and galactic purple. Seriously, who names these? GloFish are owned by Yorktown Technologies, and they achieved their brightly colored fish by inserting a gene. They are currently the only genetically modified animal to be sold in the USA. Coming in at number 8, we have sudden death mosquitoes. How fun do these sound? Yeah, not fun at all. I hate mosquitoes. Luckily, the sudden death part isn't actually aimed at us humans. Sudden death mosquitoes were developed to kill mosquitoes and not us. The insects were created to try and stem the spread of dengue fever. The World Health Organization said that, as things were in 2012, half of the population of the planet was at risk of contracting dengue. So enter the sudden death mosquito, a breed of the insect that is either sterile or unable to produce healthy offspring. Therefore, this lowered the number of infectious mosquitoes out there. Coming in at number 7, we have Super Salmon. Super Salmon! It sounds like a really weird superhero. Actually known as Aqua Advantage Salmon, these are genetically modified huge salmon with an added growth hormone. The modified fish grows to full market size in half of the time it takes natural salmon. Concerns have been raised as to the ethics of this practice, and also to the possibility that the fish would swim out to unobserved waters and compete with natural wild salmons. Coming in at number 6, we have micro pigs. In China, scientists genetically engineered teeny tiny pigs with the purpose of selling them as pets. They are also working on the ability to provide custom ordered pigs too, where customers can choose the color coat of the pig and what patterns they have, which I think is actually just taking it a little bit too far. Coming in at number 5, we have this see-through frog. There are also some see-through fish out there which are pretty cool. This see-through frog was created in 2007 so that scientists could allow for research to take place without dissection. The Japanese scientists hope that the see-through skin will allow for observation of organs and blood vessels. Researchers sometimes inject the frog with fluorescent markers to observe what is happening in their bodies. For me, it's crazy that you can see an animal's heart pump through its skin. Coming into number 4, we have featherless chickens. This actually makes me feel really sad. Featherless chickens have only been developed for the sole purpose of poultry farming. Developed in 2002, the birds created at the Hebrew University in Israel were designed to save money for chicken farmers who would not need to pluck these birds. Critics of the creation say that this is unfair to chickens who will enjoy a lower quality of life. They'd be more prone to sunburn as well as more likely to suffer in cold climates. Basically, these sad bald chickens are just created to feed us and that's it. Coming in at number 3, we have Dolly the clone sheep. Dolly was cloned from a cell and was planted into a surrogate ewe. Dolly was named as such because the cells used to clone her were taken from a sheep's mammary glands. The owner said that there are no more impressive mammaries out there than those owned by Dolly Parton. Thus, Dolly was born. Really creepy. Dolly died shortly before turning 7, which is quite young for a sheep. Some scientists speculate that this is because the sheep that she was cloned from was 6 years old, meaning that she could have been born with adult cells. Coming into number 2, guys, brace yourself, we have glow-in-the-dark cats. Okay, so these glow-in-the-dark cats not only glow in the dark, but they also fight AIDS, which is a sentence I didn't think I was gonna say today. In 2011, scientists genetically modified cats, inserting one gene into them that helps them resist feline AIDS. They also inserted a glow-in-the-dark protein called GFP because why not? The GFP protein is found in jellyfish, and scientists used it in cats to make it easy to spot the altered genes. Not only are these cats the literal cutest, they're also helping further research into stopping the spread of HIV. Coming into number one, we have a human pig. Oh my goodness. In January 2017, scientists successfully injected a pig embryo with human cells. The reasoning behind this is because scientists are experimenting with ways to grow organs in order to meet demands for transplants. The team at the Salk Institute for Biological Studies in San Diego have called the new species Chimera. This means it is an organism that contains cells from two different species. It's a hybrid. This is the first time a human chimera has been created. Previous versions include a rat and mouse hybrid. So guys, that was the top 10 animals created by science. Do you think scientists should be making animals, or should we leave nature to itself? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. For now, I'm Rebecca Felgate. If you like this video, make sure you show me by giving it a good thumbs up, sharing it with a friend, and staying subscribed to Most Amazing Top 10. Also, don't forget to check out our Instagram and our Patreon links in the description box. Thanks guys for watching to the very end. Why not check out our top 10 biggest scientific breakthroughs and the top 10 science experiments that went horribly wrong? Until next time.